So we're taking advantage of this opportunity today to demonstrate the capabilities of two test corridors. We have the Virginia Connected Corridor and we have the Virginia Automated Corridor. Right now we're on the hot lanes operated by Transurban as part of the VAC. This is an environment that will allow us to test and evaluate connected and automated vehicle technologies, specifically from the driver point of view, looking at research questions that involve the driver, but it also allows for evaluation of the systems themselves, so system validation and shakedown testing, for example. So right now we have an example of where we come up on a motorcycle who's going to brake hard.
Braking
to
avoid collision.
The vehicle responds by issuing an alert and then also applied the brakes. So all the braking was done by the vehicle. I grabbed the steering wheel just because I was ready to take over if necessary. But the vehicle handled that event, slowed us down, and kept us from colliding with the motorcycle in front. Around this bend, we're going to be approaching a construction zone. And we'll take that opportunity to demonstrate the connected vehicle side again, this time the vehicle to infrastructure. So we're actually communicating with the environment as well as beyond cars, as well as the construction zone. And as we approach here, this is also another demonstration where we
braking to avoid collision
are accounting for other users on the roadway. So for example, this is a construction worker who's wearing a vest that's equipped with a dedicated short-range communication system so that he's also communicating with us and we're aware of his position. That was an example of where he started to walk out. The vehicle detected a possible collision between us and his path and alerted us and actually brought us to a stop automatically. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and re-engage automation.
Automated control engaging.
So again, the vehicle is back in control, maintaining our speed and our lane position, monitoring the environment ahead. So what we're coming up on now is we have a police cruiser who's stopped on the side of the road. For example, whether there's a vehicle in distress or he has someone pulled over. Now, state law obviously requires that we move over to the left lane to give more room if there's an available slot to do so. The vehicle recognizes that there's a stopped police cruiser, engages our turn signal and automatically changes our lanes over to the left so that we can give them as much space as they need. And now what we'll see is that police cruiser is now moving. He's in the lane directly behind us. And as he gets closer, vehicle recognizes that we have an emergency vehicle that's approaching, and we will then automatically change lanes over to the right again to give them the space that he needs. So here, turn signal activator, we're going to change lanes and we'll get out of his way and let him pass. So although it can handle a lot of situations, this isn't representative of a fully automated vehicle. And so there are situations or scenarios within the environment that the vehicle will decide it can't handle and needs to turn control back over to the driver. So here, for example, we have a warning, unknown condition ahead, and it actually transfers control back to me as the driver. We have the stalled car here on the right, so I manually change lanes to the left so that I can steer around the obstacle.